Chuck, is that up, mate?
There we go. He's getting a hat on also. Mate, you know what? I was just seeing you do the neck brace there, which is something I haven't seen you do before, and it looked like you was actually enjoying it a bit too much.
Home away from home, that.
But you look like you're incorporating a lot of strength work as well into the regime.
Yeah, right? Just filling out all the time. We was talking about it before, and at the start of my career, we was sort of caught between super feather and lightweight, whereas I think the work I do with Matt in the gym and all the strength work I'm doing with Andy, and obviously I am only 21, so I am going to get bigger anyway. Starting to fill out into a solid lightweight now, so... I'm starting feeling stronger all the time in the ring, in my spars and in the fight. So, yeah, we're just getting there, improving on every area.
Sharpness looking good as well. I mean, I know you had a couple of cameras on you there, but, you know, regardless.
Do you know what? It's amazing what a few cameras does for you, innit? Triples the bleeding speed, doesn't it?
You know, you've been talked about as a work in progress, and, you know, we talked about this before, you know, as each camp you're getting better, etc., etc. But it really does look like there are, you know, a few different things in your arsenal, actually, looking at that.
Yeah. We've been saying it for a while now. It's going to take a little bit of time for what happens in the gym to transfer on the night, but we're starting to get there now. From my last, last three or four fights, we've started seeing them improvements since the one in Bilbao, and it's slowly getting to what we expect now, and we're still not 100% there. There's still a lot of things that... that we know I'm capable of, which aren't quite in there yet, but each fight we're getting a little bit closer and closer to our expectations, and like I said a minute ago, just improving on every area. So yeah, we're happy with it, and next time I'm hoping for more of the same and a bigger jump in improvements than we've seen.
Is your confidence levels going up as well then? Because obviously, you've always been a confident lad, you've always loved the boxing, etc. But that's something you've got to build with time as well. Do you feel like your confidence levels are going up and your IQ level in boxing?
Definitely. Especially with my performances in the gym, where the improvements are getting rapid, and I'm sparring good fighters and holding my own against them and getting the better of some of them. Obviously, I'm not going to start slagging people and start saying what happens in the spars and that, but yeah, even in the ring on the night as well, where I'm still showing them improvements as the opponents get better. Like we had Joe Ducker, I came in with a winning record, and that's probably my best performance to date. The fight after that at the MEN, we was preparing for Lee Glover, another lad with a winning record. There was a late change in opponent, but again, I've shown improvements again in that fight. And last time out, Duffex, that very experienced fighter, again, winning record, a lot of stoppages, and I was really comfortable with it. It was a physical fight, which I've probably not faced many of them in my career so far, where they're really giving it a go, and I felt really comfortable in my gas and how I handled that. So it's just ticking boxes as we go on, and I just want to carry on doing that.
Do you sort of sit down with Matt and Ricky and the rest of the team to, you know, analyse fights after the fights? Did you do that?
We do. Yeah. We always do that. We haven't done it on the last fight yet, because obviously we went away and Matthew had a little holiday after it, and we've just come back to the gym preparing for the next fight, which we should have some sort of news on hopefully this week or next. Yeah. But yeah, we'll get round to watching that back, and again, there's always improvements, especially when we compare it to how I am day in, day out, what we're used to seeing. We have generally been pleased with it, but it's never perfect, and you can always do that little bit more.
What's your favourite part of training and boxing? What's your favourite part that you look forward to the most?
The sparring. I love the sparring. I think you ask most boxers that, it's the same sort of answer. I love all the training, to be honest. I can't stand the dieting, that's the only thing I'm not so keen on, but even if I weren't being a professional boxer, I think I'd still do all the training, all that. I like the circuits, I like the pad work, I love the sparring. Bar bags and maybe, but it's got to be done, hasn't it?
But you know, your dad basically made the bar bag famous, same with Ray, you know.
Yeah, well, thanks for that.
Are you obviously is comeback's actually been rescheduled? I don't know if I can say the date yet, but it's been rescheduled, and it was going to happen before. Obviously, it didn't happen. It's been rescheduled. I mean, that must be quite an exciting thing for you to think about as well. You have to get to relive those steps again with your old man and see the walkout and see the crowd and everything like that.
Yeah, it's a weird one with my dad, because even though he's my dad, I'm used to seeing him all the time, I still, he's one of my favourite fighters, so, and I'm always watching his fights back, not just because we've got similarities and there's things I can learn from watching the fights, but like, he's one of my favourite fights to watch, because it's so entertaining, and the atmosphere at the shows, which I missed out on, so it is exciting to be able to see like a little snippet of that. Because I think it's still being scheduled for the back end of the year, so look forward to that. But he was looking so well in his preparation before it did get put back. We all saw how much weight he lost and how well he was looking. But when we sparred, like Matt said before, he weren't just getting the weight off. Like, he was ring fit as well. We did 6-3s and he was. Like, neither of us were holding anything back, and it was at a very good pace, and he managed to belt out 6-3s, which I think is difficult for anyone. Yeah. So, especially when you've still got an arse print in the pub booths and that. So, he's done really well. So, dead excited.
Yeah, and he didn't put it back on when he went on holiday and all that sort of stuff. And
put a little bit back on, but he's straight back in the gym now, and he's back dieting, and it's fair play to him.
So you've got the benefits of all that sort of history and knowledge with your uncle and your dad, and nutrition's moved on so far, hasn't it, and training methods and everything, but looking at you today, there's still a lot of the old-fashioned training techniques that are still there, that your uncle and dad used to use.
Yeah, we do... like the bar bag religiously, and we saw some with my gimp mask on there doing the net the network, but we've got like a good mixture, because a lot of the stuff we do with Andy in the strength works all quite new, and like I've not seen loads of people do it before, so we're getting we always go back to the old school. We do the sprints religiously, the bar bag, all that sort of stuff.
Now, departing from that slightly, because we've been talking about this in the gym anyway, but we've been talking about a fight coming up, which is splitting everyone's opinion at the minute. It's Conor Benn and it's Chris Eubank Jr. You think Conor might do it?
Yeah, I do. Yeah. I think it's a very tough fight, and I don't think anyone can hand on heart say they know how it's going to go, but I am backing Conor. I think it's going to take a lot out of Chris getting down to that weight, and I think the way, with Conor being a small target and he likes to use that low head movement, I think Chris will struggle to hit him, and I think he'll have so much energy, Conor, not having to make weight. I think any fighter will say that's probably the hardest bit of the training for a lot of people. So being able to go into your camp knowing that you're literally only eating to suit your performance, not to shift the weight, he'll be able to get everything absolutely spot on, and he'll feel $1 million. So I do think Conor's well capable to do it. So big ask, but I'm going with him.
Yeah. Now, one thing I've been looking at, it's a really sort of interesting fight. One thing I always think about is that Groves couldn't drop Eubank Jr., but a lot of people are saying they think Conor can with the speed, etc. Do you think Conor can actually stop Eubank?
I think he could do, yeah. Like you say, there's that speed element, and he probably won't be used to fighting anyone quite as quick, and he's powerful enough to hurt anyone, Conor. I think you can see how explosive he is, and again, how much will that weight take out of Chris if that punch resistance will be there, having it doesn't look like he's going to too many drastic measures getting the weight off, but can't see that being true. So I think he can do it. I wouldn't be surprised if it goes to points, though. I think Conor, with his low head movement, I think he'll just be landing a lot more. But he definitely can hurt him. I think he can hurt anyone.
Now, there's nobody better to ask than yourself, for coming from a fighting family with your uncle and your dad, both boxing, at a very high standard and high level. With the pressure that comes with having family involved in boxing, it doesn't always work, father-son relationships, so to speak. But you know about this, having a legend as a dad, there was pressure on you when you turned over. These two guys have sort of forged their own legacy as well. But you know, what's that like? Did you ever have that conversation with your old man about his involvement, what his involvement would be at the beginning of your career?
Well, in the amateurs, I always worked with my dad and Matthew. Like we did it. Like we split it between my dad, Matt, and my amateur gym, and it worked really well. But it was sort of when we did make the decision to turn pro, you can't have too many voices all at once. It gets confusing and things like that. So I'd always done the majority of the work with Matt, and like we get on dead well. And it was like the natural move to go with Matt. But my dad's always there with his advice, and obviously he's my manager as well. So I have sort of got the best of both worlds. His gym's only down the road as well. So yeah, we have cracked it.
Yeah, yeah, brilliant, mate. And just finally, you mentioned about the potential date coming forward. I know we can't speculate too much on the date, but you're thinking perhaps sometime October, November time.
Yeah, yeah. So end of October, early November, it's looking like. We have got a date that it's likely to be. So we're preparing for that, and should know for definite in the next week, I'm hoping. But like we've put our foot down now, and we're treating it as if it is set in stone.
Fantastic. All right. Well, it's always good to catch up with you, mate. Make sure you wash that gimp mask on the way out, and we'll see you again next time.
It's a bit funky, that, isn't it?